We continue with the explanation of the prose part of Unit 5, the Summit Within. We have finished in the last paragraph of page number 77. Let's continue. Glimpsing a peak in the distance, I get transported to another world. I experience a change within myself which can only be called mystical. So if you see that overcoming all the obstacles, you can see the zenith of happiness in front of you. The aim what you have been aiming for is right in front of you. You would feel somewhere on cloud nine that happy. So that particular happiness cannot be defined in words also. You feel it's mystery, it's mystical, something is mystical about it. By its beauty, aloofness, might, ruggedness and the difficulties encountered on the way, the peak draws me to it as Everest did. So he says, yes, it is very beautiful a sight. You will feel that you are on the sky. You are literally floating in the sky because you are that close to sky. Because you are on the highest peak of the world. Aloofness, its height, its mightiness, its ruggedness, the terrain of it, it's very, very difficult to climb. The difficulties which were faced, all things draw people. These are the qualities of the Everest which draw people towards that mountain. That is why people don't even think about their lives to be in danger. They do make an attempt over there, try at least, whether they can conquer the Everest. It is a challenge that is difficult to resist. Definitely, if you, as I said, human mentality is if somebody challenges you of something, you definitely want to do it. So, all these qualities of the mountain actually make it quite intriguing, quite like you can say a kind of a suspense movie which you would like to watch till the end and know what is the ending and how does it feel to know the ending of it. So this is how the mountain attracts us towards it. Looking back, I find that I have not yet fully explained why I climbed Everest. It is like answering the question, why you breathe? Why do you help your neighbor? Why do you want to do good acts? There is no final answer possible. So these questions which I just read out are very difficult to answer. Why do you breathe? A very substantiate answer, a spiritual answer, a biological answer, scientific answer, everything is possible. Why do you do kind acts? Has somebody compelled you to do it? No. You do it because you want to do it. Certain things are left unanswered, certain questions. And if the narrator has been asked why Everest, he also will have no answer to it. And then there is the fact that Everest is not just a physical climb. The man who has been to the mountain top becomes conscious in a special manner of his own smallness in this large universe. This universe has got many, many different elements in front of which we are, like I would say, a meager unit, a little, like, don't even exist. Like, if you stand in front of the Everest, you would see that you, when compared to the universe's creation, is nothing in comparison. You're nothing in comparison. So, he knows that when compared to the universe's creations, we are nothing in it. Their mightiness and humility are two such aspects which teach us a lot. The physical conquest of a mountain is only one part of the achievement. There is more to it than that. It is followed by a sense of fulfillment. It is satisfaction of a deep urge to rise above one's surroundings. If I would go and climb a very small mound or a hill, that would not give me that much of happiness. If I would go and conquer Everest, a kind of a self-confidence would come in me saying that I can overcome any kind of difficulty in my life. It's not only about the physical aspect, it's about the mental aspect, the psychological aspect also and the spiritual aspect also. It is the eternal love for adventure in man The experience is not merely physical, it is emotional, it is spiritual. There are glaciers also, this Khumbu glacier over there, which you need to cross after camp 1. That glacier, every now and then, glaciers are moving rivers of ice. Every now and then, glacier keeps shifting and it lets open to crevices, like crevices are seen. But to overcome that kind of a glacier, you're walking literally on glacier where you can fall deep into the crevices and there is no survival chance. You need to have a very strong willpower, belief in God, belief in yourself that yes, I can do it. It's emotional, it's spiritual, it's everything. Consider a typical climb towards the summit on the last heights. You are sharing a rope with another climber. You form in. He cuts the steps in the hard ice. Then he belays you and you inch your way up. There's a single rope and when you reach almost the peak, there's one single rope on which everybody gets hooked up like that. Particular hook is there. They attach themselves. And actually the person who's climbing ahead of you makes paths for you to come up and you do the same for the other. So what are you doing here? It now comes a human chain helping each other. And the sense of trust in you is acting hard. It's like acting on you very nicely. You strain every nerve as you take every step. Famous climbers have left records on the help of the help given by others. Now those who are very famous climbers must have climbed Everest many a time. So they have written in their records, the write-ups, that they have been helped by many people now and they have helped also. They have also recorded how they needed just that help, else they might have given up. Breathing is difficult. You curse yourself for having let yourself in for this. So when you reach over there, there is no looking back. Aap ek phone karke bolo, helicopter, aaj jao, mujhe le jao yahan se. Nobody will come. That height helicopter also doesn't come. So when you reach there and you're running out of breath over there, oxygen supply the brain mein nahi ja raha hai and you feel giddy, then you curse yourself. Apne aap ko aap kosate ho ki main yahan kyun aayi. You wonder why you have undertook the ascent. There are moments when you feel like going back. It would be sheer relief to go down instead of up. But almost at once you snap out of that mood. Pessimism does start acting upon you, saying don't do it. It's you can't do it. Pessimistic attitude does act upon your mind. But it is how your mind reacts to such pessimistic thoughts. Will you fight back? Or will you give up in that kind of thought process? There is something in you that does not allow you to give up. And you go on. Your companion keeps up with you. Just another 50 feet or 100 maybe. So you keep telling yourself, you keep telling your fellow companions over there. Come on, it's only 50 feet. Come on, it's only 100 feet left. How much? You ascended so many meters above sea level you are. And why only 50 feet or 100 feet is left? Why do you want to give up? So here comes a bonding between the people who are climbing along. You ask yourself, is there no end? Like you would feel, ab khatam nahi hoga kya? Ye, will it not come to an end? You draw inspiration from others, from each other. Now you can see that the other person is struggling, still he is proceeding. So you look at him and you learn from that fellow companion of yours. And then, without first being aware of it, you are at the summit. When you allow yourself positive vibes to be imbibed by your body, definitely you will see yourself on the summit. Looking around from the summit, you tell yourself that it was worthwhile. When you reach over there and look around, you forget every physical torture you've been through and you feel on cloud 9. That feeling is beyond any words to say. If you're lucky, the sun may be on them. The surrounding peaks look like a jeweled necklace around the neck of your summit. So you standing in the center and the peaks around, if there is sunlight, and you will see when the sunlight shines upon the peaks, you will feel that they are pearls of a single string of necklace, and everywhere you can see the glistening snow on the peak of the mountains. Below you see vast valleys sloping into the distance. It is an ennobling, enriching experience. to just look down from the summit of a mountain. Like that ennobling and enriching experience, that kind of a feeling, that kind of a joy that you have, could have done it, you have made it to the summit, ennobles you, like, you know, makes you satisfied from within the limit of your heart, the depth of your heart, that yes, I could do it. You bow down and make your obeisance to whichever God you worship. Like, you believe in God and you definitely thank God that He allowed you, He didn't take away your life, He allowed you to be part of such a beautiful moment. I left on Everest a picture of Guru Nanak. Rawat left a picture of Goddess Durga. Pudorji left a relic of the Buddha. Edmund Hillary had buried a cross under a cane. When you reach the summit, a cane has been made over there. What is a cane? Like stones were taken from nearby and then a kind of small mound was made. So every person going on the Everest leaves a small mark of his or her over there, stating that I have been over there. They would come down, but the things what they have left over there would be there only. These are not symbols of conquest, but of reverence. Like, reverence is the feeling where thankfulness, humility. I am such a small part of the universe and you are so mighty. That kind of a feeling. So you don't leave it because boast, you have to boast ki dekho main meri wo cheez wahan padi. It is not like that. It is that you are humble enough to accept that I am only a meager part of it, so I can leave a small portion of my life, a part of parcel of my life over there. The experience of having climbed to the summit changes you completely. There is another summit. It is within yourself. That's what I had told you earlier also. You summit something within yourself. What is that? It is your own mind. Each man carries within himself his own mountain peak. And what is that mountain peak? The obstacles, the physical endurance is what he had suffered. Those are the difficulties. And the mountain peak is your conquest. The mountain peak within yourself is your conquest over those difficulties. He must climb it to reach a fuller knowledge of himself. It is fearful and unscalable. Sometimes we say, itna sara dukh, why only me? Why am I the only person suffering over here? Why is God doing this to me? So it's like that unscalable part of your life. You cannot even, if you give up to it, you can't do anything about it. Then you are a loser in your life. It cannot be climbed by anyone else. You yourself have to do it. The physical act of climbing to the summit of a mountain outside is akin to the act of climbing the mountain within. If you are ready to face the difficulties within your mind and body and soul, you can definitely conquer anything in your life. The effects of both the climbs are the same. Whether the mountain you climb is physical or emotional or spiritual, the climb will certainly change you. It teaches you much about the world and about yourself. I venture to think that my experience as an Everester has provided me with the inspiration to face life's ordeals resolutely. So when he had gone to that expedition and had come back, he might have come across many problems in his life, but he never gave up because that was the impact of climbing the peak. Okay? Climbing the mountain was a worthwhile experience. The conquest of the internal summit is equally worthwhile. The internal summits are perhaps higher than the Everest. Everest is just a physical challenge. If your body can endure, you can get on to the peak. But life, Everest might be a trek of say around 20 days. Life is like you have throughout the life you need to keep struggling. Everest is a meager challenge when compared to the life's challenges. So when a person can conquer Everest, the moral is that you can definitely conquer what is no matter what is the problem in your life. So basically never give up. Try at least. Keep trying. Someday you will succeed. Aaj nahi, kal sahi, kal nahi, parso sahi, but someday you will succeed in your life. Success comes to some people very early and success comes to some people very late. those who have the patience to wait for that success are the happiest ones on the earth. So no matter what you go through, what you've been through, remember there's always a, I would say, sunrise after a sunset. That's all for the chapter's explanation. I will be sending you Everest YouTube's videos link about Everest. Do see, it is very, very beautiful, and you can see the number of problems you have to face to climb the Everest. Thank you.